Hey guys, and welcome back to Vlogs and Frogs. My name's Ryan Peterson, and we're out here right now, and we're gonna learn all about this little cutie right here. I know it's hard to see, but obviously we're gonna get up close. This is called a pill bug, otherwise known as roly-poly, so let's just get on into it.
These cuties have a very oval-shaped body, and it's made up of about three different segments: their head, their thorax, and their abdomen. On their head, they have one pair of eyes and one set of antennae. Across their backs, they have these seven overlapping plates that act as their own special suit of armor. Each plate covers a pair of legs and all the meaty parts underneath. The adults grow to be only about a 1/16 of an inch long. That's so tiny. And juveniles are only about half that. Now, although most species of pill bugs are gray on top and a lighter shade on their underside, there are plenty of species out there. Over 10,000 different species of pill bugs exist actually, and maybe even more that haven't been found. Some even have yellow, red, brownish, or even purple spots on their back. Now, the common pill bug originated in the Mediterranean area, but has since been brought to almost all corners of the world. They are primarily dominant in temperate climates and can be found all around the United States, South Africa, Canada, and oh, so many others. You can find them in forests, fields, gardens, and even very urban areas. They live in areas that are moist with little light, and the temperature has to be just right. Not too hot and not too cold. The Goldilocks of isopods, really. Now, the most notable thing about pill bugs is the way they can roll into a ball when threatened. This is where they get the nickname roly-polies. Their specialized skill is called conglobation. The skill allows them to be fully covered by their exoskeleton, which protects that soft, mushy tissue underneath. They are nocturnal, so they're out moving about at night. They also gather in groups and can actually communicate with each other. They are able to use some senses like sight, smell, and touch. Their eyes can detect light, but otherwise, they aren't the best at seeing things. They utilize their smell to find mates and food. Pill bugs are primarily detritivores, feeding on decomposing leaves and other decaying matter. They will even snack in your garden, and on top of all that, they will eat their own poop. This actually is very resourceful because they will digest the food nutrients that they weren't able to digest the first time around. And if all else fails and food is scarce, larger ones will actually cannibalize the smaller ones, especially if they're injured. So maybe it's not so easy to be a pill bug. Also, they have these glands that produce very unpleasant secretions, which repel predators, and along with their armor, most smaller predators cannot get past these defenses. Though there are some tropical ant species that have long pinchers, which can literally pry apart balled up pill bugs. Some spider species are pretty good predators too, as well as birds, like the common starling. Now, pill bugs begin their life as eggs. The eggs contain yolk that the young develop on, and the eggs stay inside the female parent in a pouch called the marsupium. While still inside the mother, the eggs actually hatch in there, and after 3 or 4 days, they crawl out of their mom, and after they shed their skin several times, they become adults. And then they live an average of about a year and a half, and then they die, and the life cycle restarts. And that's the beauty of the roly-poly.